Just getting up in the morning and watching the sunrise every morning. That's basically my favorite part. You know, just watch the birds follow you and eat the bait as it comes out the traps or the fish as you throw them out while you're trawling. Bobby Lovell, I'm from St. Bernard Parish, Louisiana. Commercial fisherman, just about my whole life. I wake up about 3:30 in the morning. I go pick up my deckhands and we get down in Hopedale for about 5 o'clock in the morning. We get our bait and we load our boat and we run 600 traps and we'll be in for about 2 o'clock in the evening. Hopefully with a boatload of crab, but it don't always turn out that way. And we come home and I sort the crabs. We package our own crab and we ship them to the Northeast. And then from there, they turn just a few dollars worth of crab into big money crab. You know, that's where the profits really start to begin.
Like I said, once you start doing it, it's pretty much what you're going to do. I don't know too many people that grew up around that don't do it. You know, once you start, it's in your blood.
Let me see if my mother-in-law can put the dogs in her. They want me on a porch to talk to them, so can we put them in a...
Come on. Let me take them in the back, because they're going to bark no time on the porch. Come on.
They haven't bitten nobody all week. I'm so proud of them.
What do you think would happen to St. Bernard if, like, the seafood industry disappeared?
It would devastate St. Bernard Parish, I think. You know, it just wound up like a western town, basically. I mean, I'm sure, like I said, they get the oil refineries people work at, but it'd lose its heart, basically, if the seafood industry disappeared. Culturally, you know, that's what St. Bernard's known for. I don't know what it'd wind up looking like, but I wouldn't want to see it, I could tell you that. And I hope my kids never see it neither.